time, I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Two running backs will take the field today in hopes of leading their team to victory. It's the Redskins going up against the Eagles. So let's send you up to Pennsylvania. Standing by in Philadelphia are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Thank you very much, Larry. We are here on a beautiful afternoon for football. Today, rivals square off in the NFC East, and we've got a great matchup between the Washington Redskins and the Philadelphia Eagles. Hi again, everyone. I'm Brandon Godden. Welcome to the NFL on EA Sports. With me, as always, Charles Davis. And, Charles, we look at a matchup like this. It's really the running backs that may take center stage here today.
And in today's football, they're still valuable, not just as runners, but guys who can catch the ball as well. It's really the number of touches that determines things these days.
Sturgis now to do the honors and get us started. And off we go from Lincoln Financial Field. On the return, this is Rashad Ross now. And he'll be taken down just past the 20 at about the 21-yard line. And here comes Kirk Cousins and the Washington Redskins. And what a game they had on Thanksgiving, albeit in a loss to Dallas. Cousins put it in the air, Charles, 53 times, 449 yards, three touchdowns in the losing effort.
And people want to question whether Kirk Cousins can handle that type of a load, right? Throwing it 53 times, but he did it quite effectively on a day where they had to get away from the running game because they were playing from behind. I think he's a guy that's made to order to be their quarterback, especially when they're running the football effectively.
Play fake here on first down. And his first pass is incomplete. Pierre Garçon, the intended receiver. And now it's second down. First offensive series forthcoming. DeSean Jackson, wide receiver that certainly needs no introduction in this league.
He's truly one of those don't blink guys, because as soon as you do, he's past you and in the end zone and doesn't mind letting you know about it too.
Second down following the incompletion. A second down throw for Cousins. Got his target, Pierre Garçon. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
They go play action here on first down. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. It's a 4-yard pickup, and that'll bring up second down. So we've reached the end of a fairly even first quarter of play. Can't wait to see what the second quarter has in store. And we're back to Philadelphia after this.
This presentation of the NFL on EA Sports is brought to you by Snickers. You're off your game when you're hungry. Snickers satisfies.
Back live, Charles Davis to my right. I'm Brandon Godden. It's Redskin football to begin quarter number two. They've got it 2nd and 6 to start things out. Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. Again, it's Cousins. Crowder's got it over the middle. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. And welcome back. The offensive unit, they took the timeout. And now they get set to line up as we resume action. Cousins. Jackson's got it over the middle. And he'll get it out to midfield. Let's see. Yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. And we're back. The offense had a chance to talk things over. We'll see what they come up with here on this next play. Second down and four.
Green, 39.
Cousins now from the 50. This one complete to Jordan Reed. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. And Charles, what a game against the Cowboys for Jordan Reed. 10 catches, 95 yards, 2 touchdowns. He seemed unguardable.
We've talked about how throughout this season, more and more people are starting to realize that Jordan Reed is probably the best route-running tight end in the league. But how about what he does after he catches the ball? His basketball background comes into play. See those crossover steps he was taking? You see those moves he was making? Jordan Reed is something else and played that game with a lot of toughness, battled through a shoulder injury to finish that game.
Cousins on first down. Caught on the right side, Reed. A gain of 6 there on first. And how about this? Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. So we're back in the offense getting set following the call of that timeout. So on second down, the field goal unit is on here as they try to get 3 before half. It's a 39-yard attempt, right hash. And Hopkins' kick is good. And it's 3-0 as the Redskins strike first. So they kick it through to take the lead. There is a little bit of time left, though, here in the second quarter.
And while they're concerned about not giving up a big return or giving up points themselves going into the half, how good do they feel, though, putting points on the board themselves right near the end of the first half?
Following the made field goal for 3, Hopkins now to kick it off. This will be fielded at the 6. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. Time running short here. They'll simply take a knee, and that should do it for half number 1. So we've reached halftime. All we have to show for the first half, a lone field goal. 3-0, our score. As we'll send you down the coast to Orlando, where we check in with our friend Larry Ridley and the EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry?
All right, let's take a look at some of the highlights from the first half. Redskins Redskins line up now at midfield. It's Cousins, a completion over the middle, and he won't be brought down until he makes it to the 28-yard line. Redskins would later kick the field goal. That'll do it for us here at EA Sports Studios. Let's get back out to Brandon and Charles for the call of the second half. Brandon.
So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. This is taken at his four. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. Philadelphia getting set to take the field. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess that in the locker room, they talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there, just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. And 10. Here's Wentz. And Salik here, left side. No gain there on the completion. Second and 10. The defense loves to hang their hat on that, don't they? You get a guy that catches the ball, but you stop him for no gain.
Without a doubt, because they're also used to trying to catch people after the catch, and they miss. And that turns into what? A huge play. We've seen it so many times. In this case, though, catch was made, put down right on the spot.
And on second and 10 now.
What's tight? Tight end's right. What's tight? Tight end's right.
They come out here in the eye.
Green 39. Green 39.
Mike by four.
On second down, Ryan Matthews. And he'll get this one up to the 26. He only got a couple on that one, so not a ton of help. They'll have a third and 8 forthcoming.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
So they'll get a little extra time to come up with this third down play as we play three quarters. But we'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. And welcome back. We are in the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point, just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. So following the run, we'll see what they do here on third down. Surveying the field. And incomplete. He had nowhere to throw, so he just tossed it away. But that brings up fourth. One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down.
Hurry up, here we go. Blue, land it.
They'll look to throw. And able to complete it to Green Beckham. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. Back to throw. And this is Ertz with it, right side. A gain of 6 there on first. So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down. He's back to throw. And his throw is going to be incomplete. He was trying to get it to Zach Ertz that time. And now it's third down. Defensive back in the game now here for third and four. Back to throw. Green Beckham has it over the middle. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. So the offense took the timeout. Looks like they're ready to go as we get set to resume the action. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun, fighting his way down to about the 35-yard line. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. So the offensive unit called the TO, and now we are ready to resume play. And the eighth play on this drive coming up.
Let's go! Gun, gun! Gun, gun!
They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he'll be taken down at the 34. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It'll be their third and final timeout. So as they talk things over, we'll step aside. And we are back here. I'm Brandon Gordon alongside Charles Davis. So the offense takes a timeout. And now we're set to get going. So here we go. Maybe the biggest kick of the game forthcoming. And now we're going to get a timeout called by the Redskins defense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. So now one of the biggest kicks of the night is forthcoming. This to potentially send us to overtime. And this one is right down the middle. And they will tie this game here in the final seconds. So this hasn't exactly been a battle of one touchdown after another, but at 3-3 now here in the fourth, it's been a pretty doggone entertaining game.
Yeah, it's kind of like a pitcher's duel in baseball, don't you think? The aficionados can appreciate a tightly fought game like this.
Yeah, but the fantasy players, not so much. So here comes the kickoff now, all even here in this fourth quarter. This is taken at his 4. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. It's Kelly, and he'll be taken down here, and that is how this one is going to come to an end. So 4 quarters wasn't enough, and we are off to overtime. Don't change that dial. It's a little teaching moment here. Overtime rules. Remind us how this goes, partner.
Okay, so in the past, we had sudden death. First team to score wins, but no longer. Now, if the team receives the ball, scores a touchdown, they win the game. If they kick a field goal, though, or don't score, the other team gets a possession. And after both teams get a possession, then we're into sudden death. First team to score wins the game.
Nothing between these two teams for 4 quarters. Here we go to begin overtime. On the return, it's Kenyon Barner. And nice work on the return as he'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. They control their own destiny here. They have the football in overtime. Obviously, a touchdown would win it.
And I think teams around the league are still adjusting to the idea of going downfield, scoring a touchdown wins the game, because they were used to just going downfield and trying to get in field goal range to win a game. Still having to make that transition, let's face it now, the ones who are doing it best know they need to go down, attack, put the ball in the end zone, and not leave it up to a field goal and give the other team a chance.
Yeah, as we said, they control their own destiny now. They begin the drive with Ryan Matthews. And he'll be tackled just past the 35 at the 36. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. They'll be down to just 1 remaining as we step aside here in overtime. Second down and the offense needing 5 yards. They'll come out in the pistol. Now a handoff here to his running back. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. It's a pickup of 6 and good enough to move the chains.
And that's a nice pickup of a first down on that second down run. And at that yardage gained, they can run that play on any down.
Time for Wentz. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he's into the end zone for the touchdown and a game winner in OT. Well, you never know what you're going to expect when you come to the stadium to call a game. Sometimes you get good ones, sometimes you get bad ones, sometimes you get great ones. And that's what we had here. What an exciting finish on that last big play.
And I think that as we look at it, when you're talking about a great finish, which went along with a game that obviously was dramatic because we did get into overtime, what type of play calls do you have left? What have you not shown? Or what have you made an adjustment to what you've worked on all the way through? It's going to give you...